Administrator Bridenstine's busy week, technologies for a new era of aviation and research, and highlighting science on the International Space Station. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. It was a week full of activity for our Administrator Jim Bridenstine. On July 23rd, he participated in a Center for Strategic and International Studies event celebrating NASA's 60th anniversary. Former NASA Administrators Sean O'Keefe and Charlie Bolden were also on hand. That same day, Bridenstine was at the White House for the Made in America Showcase, which featured the Orion spacecraft that flew on a test flight in 2014. Later in the week, the administrator testified during a hearing on Capitol Hill about the status of the James Webb Space Telescope.
This has never been done before in the history of the world, and it really sets the stage for who in the world is the leader in astrophysics.
He also discussed Webb with Nobel Prize winner John Mather and our Associate Administrator for Science, Thomas Zurbuchen, during an episode of our new show, Watch This Space. Bridenstine also visited our Goddard Space Flight Center to help celebrate National Intern Day. Our chief scientist, Jim Green, says a paper suggesting liquid water under Mars's south pole is, quote, extremely intriguing and could be studied further with future NASA missions. The finding is based on data from a radar instrument aboard the European Mars Express spacecraft. Development of the instrument was led by the Italian Space Agency, with half of the instrument provided by NASA. We participated in the Experimental Aircraft Association's 2018 Air Venture event in Oshkosh, Wisconsin. It was an opportunity to showcase the latest technologies being developed to propel the agency into a new era of aviation and research, including the all-electric X-57 Maxwell and the recently announced supersonic X-59 Quest aircraft. NASA representatives joined counterparts from government, academia, and international organizations at the 7th Annual International Space Station Research and Development Conference, July 23rd through 26th in San Francisco. The event highlighted discoveries and research on the space station. We worked with the University of Texas at Dallas to modify an audio tape recorder at our Johnson Space Center in Houston that is the only functional remaining device capable of playing back more than 100 30-track audio tapes, some of them from the Apollo 11 mission. This made it possible for the tapes, which contained previously unavailable conversations between the Apollo 11 astronauts, flight controllers, and others supporting the mission, to be digitized.
Go ahead. Can we get permission to go to a reverse condition on our computers? We've had another fault.
And now all 19,000 hours of the recordings from Apollo 11 are available for download. For more details, go to nasa.gov/new-apollo-audio. The online streaming universe has a new way to keep up with our exciting missions and thought-provoking discoveries. Users of Roku digital media streaming devices can now install and watch NASA's new Roku channel for free to access NASA content. This channel is a version of the NASA app available on iOS, Android, Amazon Fire TV, and Apple TV devices. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.